Welcome to Weld.com. I'm Paul, your host, and today I'm going to be talking about and demonstrating welding 309 filler metal using the SMAW process, also known as stick welding. Everybody knows stick welding. And you know, 309 is one of the most commonly used rods, and you can find it everywhere, from the garage to the field and everywhere in between. So let's get started. First off, what is 309 filler metal used for? In most cases, when welding dissimilar metals, or to be more specific, carbon steel to stainless steel. The most commonly used is a 309 filler metal because of its higher ferrite content. And of course, the higher the ferrite content can maximize weld dilution and prevent weld cracking. Does anyone have any idea the tensile strength of the 309 filler material, especially the SMAW? Anybody? Well, here we'll talk about it. The tensile strength is 87,000 PSI, believe it or not. That's pretty strong in my book. Compare a commonly known welding rod of 7018 that has tensile strength of 70,000 PSI. The 309 rod has 17,000 more PSI than the 7018 rod that most industries use and rely on. So never underestimate the 309 rod. So today what we're gonna be using, of course, is the Lincoln Square Wave TIG 175 Pro. Very, very, very simple machine to set up. It don't have all the bells and whistles, but very good running machine. So what we're gonna set up for is the E309L16. You can run on AC or DCEP, which is electropositive. We're gonna run on electropositive today. I'm gonna talk a little bit about the profile of the 15, 16, and 17 real quick. The 15 is a convex, which is more rounded than the 16, but the 16 is a convex too. And then the 17 profile rod is a concave. So we're using 16 today, and I got it hooked up. It says I've got a little bit over 110, which you can't really tell exactly what it is because it's not digital, but we're a little warm. We're a little bit over 110. We're going to get started here in a second. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a lap joint, and then I'm going to do a T joint. On the lap joint, I'll just run one single pass and show you, and we'll talk about the profile and how the weld looks and everything. And then we'll switch over and go to the T joint, and I'm going to run three passes, multiple passes, on the T-joint, and we'll talk about the profile of that. And I'm gonna run it into 1F position. So that's flat. So anyways, let's get started. And like I always like to do, doesn't matter what kind of rod I run, I always like to start back 2 or 3 inches before I drag it into my start spot. And you can see I kind of favor the stainless side. So I'm not manipulating the rod much, just a little bit, but very quickly, and staying on the stainless side. So I got a drag angle about 20 to 25 degrees. I can tell it's tying into both the metals really well. So we're coming down. And you can see that rod angle is about the same, 20-25, same speed. So you can see I welded the lap joint and I stretched that rod and it made 8 inches. I haven't chipped the slag yet to see what it looks like, but normally you should weld down to the numbers, and then usually the rod's no good after the numbers because the stub's so hot. But anyway, I got lucky and made the whole width of the 8 inches here. So what I like to do is, like I said before, is I like to let the slag cool off, because man, if you touch that slag, it'll jump on you. And I've had it jump on my hands, my face, and it burns. The thing about it is that slag holds the heat because of the stainless. It holds the heat and it don't feel good at all. So you don't really need to beat it up, because the 16 slag removes real easy. But basically you just touch it like so. And it'll pop off there just like that. Profile of the weld looks really good to me. You know, you can see it tied into both the carbon and the stainless really good. But if you notice, when I was welding, I was kind of favoring the stainless a little bit. That's why I do that, because it'll flow to the carbon. The stainless is a little bit harder, so to get it to flow on a stainless, so that's why I kind of favor it a little bit. But you can see it tied in really nice. There's no undercut or anything. got a couple BBs, but so this 16 rod, you said it shows a little convex welding. That's exactly what it gives, you know. So anyway, we'll move on to the T-joint, and I'm gonna do multi-pass on the T-joint. So we're gonna start on this T-joint, and just like I always like to do, I start back a couple inches before I start welding. And I'm favoring the stainless side and manipulating it very quick and very short. Little short back and forth manipulation. You don't want to get too far out because 309 doesn't weld that good when you try to wide weave and stuff like that. We're coming down here and I'm hoping this rod will make it the whole way. And I'm testing it because you can see the numbers. I'm testing it. I'm almost to the end. Oh my, I'm barely gonna make it. So you can see I ran my first pass. So we'll knock the slag off. See how it pops up in there? You don't want that popping up on your skin. So I like the way this Excalibur E309L-16 runs. Runs really smooth. And if you have your heat and everything just right, your travel speed, comes out nice and slick like that. And I'll take my next pass and start right here on the stainless side and cover half that pass right there, half that bead, so I get nice coverage and tie in really good to the stainless side coming down. So then when I put my third pass on, it'll be on the carbon side and it'll tie in really good to that top bead that I'm trying to tie into. So we're on our second pass now. And I'm going back to my old routine. Start back a couple inches before I start my weld. And I'm hanging on the stainless side. Not much manipulation because I just want to cover half the weld and tie into the stainless side really good. So when I go to weld the other side, it's the other half and the carbon side. And it looks really good when it ties in and it's nice and uniform. And the profile of the weld looks really good when you run nice stringers. Getting half that bead, covering it up, half that bead, and I'm not gonna make the whole rod this time. So we're gonna have to pull off. I didn't make this one. So I initiate the arc, and when I go to tie in, I just do a quick little C formation and get right back on that stainless side. So on this one, I didn't quite make it to the end, so I had to restart. So tie-in looks really nice. Profile looks good. It's tied in really good to the stainless. And now we'll do the carbon side. Let's weld it out. So just like my normal routine, start back a couple inches, drag it, get that rod nice and hot so you can tie in, make a nice tie-in. And I'm hanging on the carbon side. Not much manipulation because I've already covered about 50 to 70% of the weld, so I want it both to look uniform, so I'm not using much manipulation. Rod angle's about 20-25 degrees. Hanging right in the middle, kind of swerving towards the carbon side a little bit. A little manipulation, not a lot. We're looking really good coming down there. And we're getting down to the number, so here we go. So So we'll initiate the weld again a couple inches back, make our quick little C formation swoop in there, tie in, and right angle 20, 25 degrees. So you can see I got my final pass on it. So we'll chip it off. And I don't like hitting it that hard. It should just fall off just like that, you know. Hit it with a wire brush, make it look real pretty and shiny, you know, like you're taking it out on a Friday night date. So I got really good color. Looks really good. And I had to stop and restart, and the restart looks good. You can definitely tell how well it tied into the carbon. Nice and uniform bead. It kind of overlapped just a little bit more than I wanted it to, but it's still fine with that. Tied in really good to the stainless too. And I like it. Looks like really good profile as well. Shiny. Got a little gold in there. So I like it. It turned out really well. I had a great time doing this video. Thanks for tuning in today. Have questions or comments? Connect with us directly to the Weld.com forum or comment below. You can also reach us through our website, chat, Instagram, or Facebook. We look forward to hearing from you. See you on the next one.